What have been some of the design challenges to a project like this?
Some of the design challenges as part of this whole project were, in particular, as you saw downstream, it was nothing but a concrete line channel that was extreme elevation and with a width of about 3 feet and depth of about 3 inches. And so that's not the kind of channel we were trying to restore. And so there were some remnant channels that we could use as a template full of concrete rubble and such, but trying to estimate that channel bank flow, which was what we designed here at the top of the bank. And then we knew our slope, so we had to tie into this concrete lining. We knew our upstream elevation from the pipes. So, but we were able to incorporate the top, the lower end of the riffle and the top end of the riffle elevations. These, as you can see, the outside meanders are a little more armored, but the inside have those point bar areas, so they don't require the heavy rock. But we're trying to incorporate those, and as well as the pools around the bends, which are deeper. And so, as you know, the grade is controlled through these riffles. And that's the two kinds of channel types that we had as cross sections, our typical riffle and typical pool. And then you kind of fill in the excavation as the outside meanders in the pool. And so the contractors did a fantastic job, as well as the team in general, in assisting them and laying out this channel and getting it constructed as was designed on the plans. One of the things too that's, I think, so important as part of our projects is that this overall stream design and the overall staging is all thought of together and integrated with the roadway construction, timing everything from the timing of the wetland plants and as well as the dewatering and the timing of moving equipment and roadways. So that's the real advantage with our whole team effort together with this project. That includes DOT, DNR, myself, and the consultant engineers. And so it's what makes these projects far more successful than they would be without everyone talking together.
Yeah, and then you get to link all these different parts together as well.
Right, right. So what we're trying to do is just trying to get it to function properly, and then we know there's going to be adjustments over time. But this whole area is designed to overbank and reduce erosion on the banks, and it will come up slowly as we get on the upland side, but that was all part of the modeling. And so the height of this elevation was approximately adjusted for a two-year event, but since most of this area is fed by stormwater pipes, and you can see water flowing out through there now, and you can see the pipes at the headwater, you can't get much more unnatural. Mm-hmm. But we're trying to recreate a more natural stream given the flashiness and through here, and we're trying to recreate, not just improve water quality. And the potential for fisheries is limited right now, given we have several miles of concrete lining, but from a wildlife perspective and from an infiltration of stormwater and reducing of total suspended solids and recreation of a diverse wetland and upland areas for migratory birds and even aesthetics and recreation, that's what we're trying to accomplish, all those things, as well as, of course, flood mitigation and trying to tie in and not flood any homes, trying to accomplish both these things at the same time.